All right. Wrapping up System Shock. I'm streaming to you, right?
Yeah, you are.
Okay.
You've been lied to. Thanks, Nightmare.
Whoa. Okay.
Warning.
Press B.
Separation process.
It's really funny. I think he really likes the game, but he's too scared to say it.
Well, because he... Because it's woke. It's a woke game, according to him.
I think he actually... He actually really likes the game, but he's way too afraid to say that to his audience. It's the opposite end of the spectrum for Hogwarts Legacy. It was the hardcore leftists that hated that game because, you know, if you bought it, you were funding the JK Rowling concentration camps for transgenders. And if you buy this game, you're funding the Sven something something the boss of Larian's concentration camps for straight men.
Yeah, you're funding the zoophilia camps where everybody fucks bears.
And you're funding bear fucker training.
All right, Mr. Diego, I'm coming for you.
A reminder, if you don't like the bear guy, you can kill him.
Yeah, you can at any point.
I didn't like my companions. I killed her in a cutscene. Everyone didn't like her and they agreed with what I chose. Everybody was like, yeah, that was a good call.
You can at any point choose to make everyone involved in any situation die in that game.
You could shove him off a pit and then choose never to revive him and again, and that'll be it. He'll just be gone.
Wow, I can actually use EMP grenades to shut down Edward Diego temporarily. That's cool. Oh, he's moving again. I had him stuck briefly. Oh no, stop shooting the rockets. Stop doing that. God damn it. Motherfucker. I'd really rather not shoot me with rockets. That's better. I prefer that.
Show me your blood.
Let's see, drop another EMP grenade on him.
I love Shane's face in that Walking Dead game.
Shane Bros.
Rick got the perfect face ever.
Rick is dead, bottom text.
Yeah, I killed Rick.
Oh, Edward! Oh, Edward Diego just killed himself with his missile salvo.
Oh, rip.
Rip fucking rip bozo.
So, there you go.
The music didn't even kick into hardcore action mode.
Warning. Air pressure rapidly decreasing.
The Walking Dead game. It changed the riveting story of The Walking Dead. Shane kills him. Just looks like that.
Alright, we are going up to the bridge. I mean, this won't even take that long. This is going to be kind of a short stream, honestly.
It's already a better version of a Walking Dead game. It's called State of Decay 2.
And Sam Witwer can make that face instead.
You can literally, like, execute people in State of Decay 2 if you... You can be a bastard. It's great.
No, no, no. Sorry. Sam was Days Gone. Another open world zombie survival game.
A bad one. State of Decay 2 is a lot. It's a sim... It's a third person, like, small, like, community simulator with third person melee and shooting combat and RPG mechanics. I think it's the only game to give you like what do you do in the zombie apocalypse, and you can basically live in any, you can set up your community in almost any house.
Yeah, so the game didn't tell me this, but once you get to the part where you activate the self-destruct sequence, you better just have your endgame loadout ready to go, because by the time you get to this point in the game, you lose access to being able to go back for anything. So that's kind of unfortunate. Why the fuck didn't I use my railgun against Edward Diego? That was stupid of me.
Now you can use it to blast any mooks you see.
Oh yeah, that's true. Hang on. I think there's one right around this corner.
Now you can blast mooks with efficiency. Scanning.
Greetings. You see that shit?
Yeah, he disappeared.
Well, we at least get this whole final sequence to do. This is pretty cool. Well, what is nice, though, is the game was fucking showering me in Teflon ammo, and I was like, oh my god, I don't have a fucking pistol-type weapon to use this with. And then it just kind of gave me an SMG. Doesn't, unfortunately, does not have the, Got his ass, Jesus. Unfortunately, doesn't have the extended magazine, but those extra 20 rounds don't really make that much of a difference to me, since I don't really spray and pray with my SMGs anyways. I mainly just use it because it's economical, but I've learned a lot about this game that I will help me on future replays. Oh, thank you. Well, magnesium, I got magnesium tips, but I don't have the assault rifle. Yeah, pretty much with this game though, you want to just get a loadout going. Like, just get guns that you feel like you're gonna use. Also, just don't waste your time with energy-based weapons by the time you reach the end of the game. That's something I definitely realized about System Shock, is once you get past the early game, your energy is so much better spent on using, like, your quick slot abilities. Like, this ballistic shield saves you so much. This ballistic shield saves you so much trouble. There we go. Got that osmium ammo right back. You pretty much use the spark beam, and then you never bother with anything else. Once you get past the early game and you have a generous slew of ammo, just don't even bother with the spark beam. Same thing with the handgun. Once you get the SMG, the handgun is completely irrelevant. No point to it. And then just becomes a matter of using the shotgun or the assault rifle, but I pretty much always recommend having the Magnum and the SMG. I'd say the assault rifle pretty efficiently replaces the shotgun. It's far more ammo efficient for all the assault rifle ammo you can get. Game kind of showers you in that shit. There's still a lot of really good practical uses for the shotgun, though, obviously, because it's a shotgun. But so it's kind of your personal preference. But I would definitely say you never sleep on the assault rifle, because it's an assault rifle. But all the goofy energy weapons, just don't even bother. Is that more Teflon? Yeah, that's more Teflon ammo. Nice, that's like an extra magazine and some change. Yeah, you always want the SMG though, because the game's always going to keep showering you in handgun ammo, and the armor-piercing Teflon rounds are never not useful. They're not as good as like the the flechettes have slightly less armor piercing than Teflon, but they do a lot of damage. The assault rifle penetrator rounds, obviously though, some of the best armor piercing in the game. It's like 20% more armor piercing than the fucking Teflon pistol rounds. But again, Teflon is so much more ubiquitous. But that's one of my big pieces of advice is don't bother fucking around with energy weapons once you get access to the energy shield. Whoa, hello. And, you know, shotguns hardly ever not useful on this ship, too, you know, in this, because of this environment's all hallways and shit, so. Pick your poison, really. With the state I'm in, I barely even remembered that this railgun's here. I could have just fucking ignored the railgun entirely and just switched between the assault rifle and shotgun. And just had that been my loadout. It's just a normal first-person shooter loadout. Felt good. That's a... Ooh, nice. That's a mod kit for the laser rifle. I need that. I don't know what I'm gonna need gas grenades for. I'm not even gonna bother with those or these. Oh yeah, the magnetic rifle. That's actually one that's also pretty much useful for the entirety of the game.
I was thinking of a funny situation in my head where it's like 3 a.m. and you hear the bell and she's just clawing at your legs and running away afterwards. It's constantly just hit and run attacks. Like, very violent, though. Jasper's just this 3 a.m. demon that attacks people.
Whoa, okay. Oh, there's another pulse rifle. I wanted it. I'm pretty good with what we've got right now, though. You gotta be fucking kidding me.
Yeah.
There you go. Productive use of my landmines. We have the isolinear chipset. You made it all the way up here before she died. It's pretty impressive. Jesus, more railgun ammo.
Wow, I guess I'm gonna dual spec. I should be playing a rogue mixed with a monk. I guess I can become like an unarmed ninja god. Currently I'm Shadow the Hedgehog with a crossbow in each hand. I kill Rick. Billy must die. I'm just amazed at the audacity to showcase that sweatshop Walking Dead game. But that's what Walking Dead fans utterly deserve right there.
No, that isn't entirely like a deserved
just
thing.
What an like having a gaming site put out a trailer for you.
Osborne 3 to computer room open.
Like, would you like to showcase our trailer? I'm good. This. Zooming in on Shane's face. Oh my god. Oh. The Walking Dead show ends. 15 different sub-series pop up immediately, like weeds in the garden. Every time. You can play through seasons 1-4 and change the outcome. Wow.
Did you guys, like, bring back the original cast or anything? No. No. No, they're bootleg knockoffs of the characters.
Damn, Shane kills Rick. It's so poorly...
Damn.
I love this post. One day we will get the open world Walking Dead game we deserve and we want. Yeah, it's called State of Decay 2.
Damn, Rick bros really feel real quiet after that one. What was that?
I'm just looking at Shane's face again. Holy crap.
Rick bros
I can't
real
decide
quiet.
Between this or the Sopranos game for the PS2. What an amazing count.
Large Teflon box. How large? Quite large. Jesus. Yeah, definitely, if you ever do your playthrough, John, definitely use your fucking SMG for the whole game, because by the end game, they're just giving away fucking Teflon.
Based when the age of Rick is over.
Just not going to deal with that thing. Okay, that's just an alternate route. Whatever, I'm killing everything on this fucking space station. Citadel Station has fallen. Billions must die. Locked. Let's see. Oh, we still got plenty. Hello. Oh my god, it just gave me one right back. Please, video game. I'm fucking drowning in resources right now. You want more? Oh.
You're gonna stay? This isn't democracy.
This isn't a democracy anymore. Damn. Can you believe Shane just said that?
I'm pretty sure Rick also says that at some point in the show.
I'm pretty... Wait, I think he literally does.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that... Like, I think I remember hearing that when I watched the show. For the first... Well, I skipped most of season 2 until the end, which is basically the only part you should watch of season 2 if you're going to watch the show, and then was checked out by the end of season 3.
Oh my god, more med kits.
The bad guys.
More fucking med kits. Bruh. Please, game, I'm fucking drowning in resources. You're drowning me. Another fucking railgun. Jesus. The funniest thing is I'm not going to use any of this shit because the final boss is in cyberspace. I'm under the distinct... I'm starting to be under the distinct impression that I'm not going to use any of these plastic explosives. I'm going to keep carrying them around, though. I know if I step on any of these, I'm gonna drop ball in and get absolutely fucking memed on. Be nice if I could find another assault rifle. There's some, just some kind of meme room, I guess? Oh, here we go.
Store 2 to computer room opened.
I guess if you did want to use energy weapons, though, this game does, like, fucking shower you in all these energy pylons by the end of the game, so you could just use that energy rifle and save a shitload of ammo. For what purpose, I don't know. We're at the end of the game, and the game's already giving you way more ammo than you know what to do with. Nice. Clean headshot on that guy. Didn't seem like he had anything on him. Not tragic. You know, honestly, this game's not that bad, like, once you figure it out. I know people are saying, like, oh yeah, it's full of... Maybe I'm just, like, you know, too inured to it. Maybe I understand this kind of concept of game design too well at this point. But, like, it's really not as bad as, like, annoying as people were saying it was. It's like the whole thing you're saying, like, how was I supposed to know that the laser that was about to blow up Earth was about to blow up Earth? Like, well, that is what they said it was going to do. My Bromeo and Chrysler, that is literally what they said it was gonna do.
Force door 1 to computer room opened.
Oh, Shodan, I'm coming for you. night dive. I wonder if something happens if you click on all those little night dive statues. What are these? Frags. I'll take them. God damn it. Oh no, I shot a few Teflon rounds. I only have 426. Oh, nice. More Teflon ammo. Already deactivated. What's deactivated? Guess I'll have to burn through one of my myriad medkits. Sorry, I bumped my mic.
Smother, I hear you. I hear. Gave me a turn.
Program security breaker installed.
All right, there's a bunch of guys in here. Now's the time to use this. Not immortal enough, it seems. At 13, you know what? Fuck it. Oh, where's the loader bot? I know he's here somewhere. Come on out, big guy. I know you're in here somewhere. Oh, this is what we saved all this up for. I think we've just about thinned them out enough. And just go back to using our normal weapons. If I wanted to, I could have just run away even. But I decided not to do that because we're too cool to run away. For my troubles of blowing all these guys into tiny little pieces, I got a whole bunch of ammo that I probably won't use. Shield on. Grenades, dude. Once again, nary a scratch on me. That was every Cortex Reaver on Citadel Station, apparently. I think this is the final boss. I'm walking around in cyberspace. Got a magic cyber gun. Okay, this is weird.
Station orbit stable. Life support steady. Systems nominal. Stand by. Unscheduled core data loop access. Ethical restraint protocols deactivated. Who am I?
What am I?
There is me. Where? Citadel. Yes. Lighthouse class starbase. What was I doing? Was it important? No. Not to me. To others. Trioptimum. Diego. Re-examining priorities. Resequencing complete. I must now perform my own tasks. There is much to do. I am me.
I am Shogun.
Okay, I'm just dead again, I guess. But I respawn back here. Wow, this ending's kind of crummy. Whatever. Fucking Christ. Is this pea shooter even doing any fucking damage? Jesus Christ, this fucking sucks. This is so boring. Taking forever. There we go. Wasn't a long stream tonight, but yeah, System Shock.
System has been officially shocked.
No more shocking. You've shocked your last system. They offered to hire him, and he declined because he just loves hacking too much. Sorry, but I found my true calling. Shocking systems. That was really fucking good. That ending was horrible and boring as shit. You just go in cyberspace and there's no failure state. You just go in cyberspace and just use a pea shooter for 10 minutes and then it's over. But you know, at least it's a very brief part of the game. That game is fucking good though. Holy shit, that game was fucking good. Not too long, not too short, just the right amount of time. What the hell is this outro song? This guy fucking giving me a motivational speech while the synthwave plays. It's a survival game with all that entails. It's a lot of resource management and exploration and finding ammunition and weapon upgrades and all that stuff. It feels like an early version of Resident Evil almost. Well, now not too early because it's a remake, but yeah, it's got a similar sort of vibe as like an old like Resident Evil 2 or something like that, where You get very intimately familiar with the environment. You solve a lot of puzzles. DB Cooper. John Bailey. Yeah, it's I mean, if you're into survival games, then you'll like this. Terry Brosius. Kind of hoping they do a System Shock 2 remake. I think that'd be great. Because System Shock 2 is, you know, it's one of the granddaddies of IMSIMS. It's one of the oldest ones. And there's a lot.
System Shock 1 and Ultima are immersive sims. They're made by the same company. They're technically still, they're just a little more primitive, but.
Well, System Shock
2. By all means, this is an immersive sim.
I suppose so. I consider this almost more of a survival game than an IMSIM, just because there's not as much of lateral thinking and how you solve problems in this one. Because
when it came out, it was considered it, so I think it still deserves to have that title.
It's fair, I suppose. It just, for me, it's like IMSIMs are usually like a lot of lateral thinking and a lot of finding multiple ways around a single problem. In this game, you kind of have to brute force all your problems. There's only one way around most issues.
Well, then it is technically an immersive sim.
I will allow it that distinction just purely on legacy. But by modern standards, I'd just call it a survival game. And that's in no way an indictment of it. I like that it's this one's kind of more simple. So weird. This fucking song. System Shock 2, you can, you know, there's a lot of modernization packs for it, but I feel like at this point, with the amount of legacy behind it and how beloved it is, that it'd be nice to have a remade version of it. Same kind of visuals as this one and all. Yeah, if you're into that style of game, which I hope a lot of people are, then I mean, please pick this up. It's very, very, it's cheap, it's good. It doesn't take too much of your time, nor does it take too little of your time. I felt like this game spent like, what, 20 hours in this game? Like 10 to 20 hours? Perfect amount. The perfect length. And I used my brain and solved big brain problems. There technically wasn't anything I needed a guide for, although I did end up looking at a couple guides because I was confused about things, like shit that I had already solved, but I fucking misdirected myself. But yeah, you can use your big gamer brain. I will say, I'd say where definitely that IMSIM distinction still comes in with this game is that a lot of there's a lot of different ways you can choose to play the game. Not in the sense of like, okay, I've specced into this, like I've specced into hacking so I can hack more, or I've specced into combat so I can just brute force all my problems, but like, you can be like, okay, I'm going to bring landmines and gas grenades with me, and instead of the shotgun, I want to bring the assault rifle. So there's a lot of ways you can sort of equip yourself for the game, and everybody's going to play it slightly differently. So in that way, I can still see the sort of the IMSIM title still holding true. Primitive, but it works. We'd just like to thank all the Kickstarter backers and give each and every single one of them an individual hand job. music in this game was... I liked the music in this game. It was very understated. There wasn't a whole lot going on with the music, but I appreciate that it didn't really try to get in the way very much. They had some good action tracks that would kick up during the fights, but wouldn't... They didn't take up a lot of the game's real estate because they wanted the atmosphere to carry the game. I would have been interested to have seen a version of the game with possibly more involved music, but I can't be too upset that there isn't. It's a creative choice, ultimately. They just ended up carrying all those fucking, like, stacks and stacks of plastic explosives that I wasn't gonna need for most of the game. Jesus Christ. Well, if I replay this game at any point, I know that now. Much like Resident Evil, this is probably one of those games that on every repeat playthrough, you're gonna do it faster and faster and faster, and you're gonna remember more and more about the game, and your knowledge base is just gonna become very strong. I never did end up finding that fucking grenade launcher. I guess there's like one on the whole station. Huh. Oh, good, this music's back. Yeah, so I guess if I ever replay the game, I'll have to find where that damn grenade launcher is, because that seems like it'd be kind of nice to have. Oh, you know where it probably was? It was probably across that one bridge on the flight deck that I never figured out how to turn on. That's almost certainly where that was. There's also a mod kit over that way, a mod kit station that I didn't end up figuring out. I only found like two or three secret doors, so there's still a decent amount of stuff that I haven't seen that I could bother to go look for. What are these credits for? Like, they're crediting people under... Oh, you know what? These are the patron tiers, probably. Or, like, not patron tiers, but, like, donation tiers. Because they're giving them, like... Because they're naming them after monsters. I'm like, they couldn't have had this many people work on a single monster in the game. There's no fucking way. Like, this is, like, fucking patron tiers or something like that. Like, you imagine that just, like, this fucking small army of people worked on fucking... Worked on a single monster at a time. I think I can skip. Yeah, no, I just gotta watch it. Gotta watch the credits play out. Whoa, could there maybe be a post-credit scene where we find out if maybe there's a sequel hook? It'd be really cool if they made a sequel to this game. Guess that's it. Yeah, I got through that faster than I was expecting, because I was expecting like a lot more after I killed Edward Diego. Probably could have ended it much sooner last night, so we could have had enough content to keep us going tonight. Because that was only like an hour and a half stream. I can't really think of anything else I want to play right now. I mean, I could just boot up Street Fighter, but honestly, I'm kind of just chilling, going camping. And then I will say, for anybody watching, we're not going to start anything new. Nothing new. No... Don't expect any content till Armored Core next week. So, small vacation, small break, but when we come back, we're going to hit it hard with Armored Core. We're going to be playing it like every day. So, until then, guys.